Hello students, good morning. This class is for class 4, social studies class, and today we are going to start new chapter number 18, our goals, rights and duties. Open your book on page number 105 and do follow. India gained independence from the British on 15th August 1947. The immediate task before our leaders was to form a government. For this purpose, a constituent assembly was set up. The members of the Constituent Assembly were elected indirectly from amongst the elected members. The Constitution was enforced on 26 January 1950. With this, India became a sovereign democratic republic. To mark this occasion, we celebrate 26th of January every year as a Republic Day. The Constitution. The Indian Constitution is a written document. It lays down the power of the government. The Indian Constitution also defines the rights and duties of the people of India. Preamble. The introduction or the preamble to our Constitution states that India is a sovereign society, secular, socialist, secular, democratic republic. Okay, students, now you turn the page. The word sovereign means that India is independent and not under any other country. The word secular, the word socialist means the constitution declares every Indian citizen to be equal. No discrimination will be made between people. Equal opportunities will be given to all Indian citizens. The word secular means that no religion will be given more importance over another in India. Every person is free to follow his or her own religion. India is a democratic republic form of government. Every person above the age of 18 has the right to vote. The people choose the representative who form and run the government. It is a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Our fundamental rights. The Constitution has laid down certain fundamental rights. This enables a citizen to live a better life. If a citizen feels that he or she is being deprived of any of these fundamental rights, he or she can go to the courts. Some of the fundamental rights are right to equality, right to freedom of speech, assembly, movement, residence, profession, etc. Right to freedom from exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, etc. Right to constitutional remedies. During a national emergency, however, these rights are suspended. Our fundamental duties. Citizens of India not only enjoy rights but also have certain fundamental duties towards the country, the society and towards other individuals. Some of these duties are to follow the constitution, to honor the national flag and anthem, to defend the country, to protect national property, etc. Directive principles of state policy. The Constitution has laid down certain guidelines or directions for the government to function better for the welfare of the people. These directive principles are only guidelines for the state. If they are violated, citizens cannot go to the court for redressal. Some important directive principles are to provide work for all men and women, to organize village panchayats, to provide equal wages for equal work. Elections. In our country, we elect and choose our leaders who form the government and run the country. The process of electing our leaders is known as election. The people who elect their leaders are known as voters, and they do so by a process known as voting. All Indian citizens above the age of 18 are allowed to vote in the election. Now you turn the page. Okay, Election Commission. The Election Commission is responsible for conducting elections in India. It plans, fixes dates, and conducts the election in a fair and impartial manner. The voters are provided with an identity card or the voter's ID, which they carry when they go to the polling booth to vote. Voting is done by secret ballot using an electronic voting machines, wherein people cast their votes by just pressing a button. Political parties. There are many political parties in India. The people who contest the election for the post of a leader from a political party is known as the candidate of that political party. The candidate who gets the maximum number of votes is elected as a leader, as the leader. He or she, with the rest of the members of the party, forms the government. The defeated party form the opposition to the government. Each political party has a symbol. Importance of voting. The right to vote is an important right, and it helps us to choose the right leader to govern the country. As a citizen of India, this right must be used carefully and responsibly. If a leader elected by us fails to work properly, we have a choice of not voting for the same candidate in the next election. The leaders are thus answerable to us. Okay, children, with this your chapter completes. In our next class, we will do the exercises. By that time, go through the chapter again and again. And if you have any problem or doubt, you will ask me, okay? This much for today's class. Have a good day. Bye-bye.